snakes have always been a source of terror to many peoples of the world. They were associated with imminent death and were harbingers of trouble. The giant snakes of the past, such as the Titanoboa, were no exception. Fortunately, humanity did not have to face this terrifying creature, which was one of the most formidable predators of its period, the Paleocene. The Titanoboa was a species of extinct snakes, assigned to the only genus Titanoboa. Based on the structure of the skeleton, scientists conclude that the snake was a close relative of the boa constrictor. Its name also indicates this, since boa is translated from Latin as boa. Before we dive into the topic, please don't forget to click the subscribe button and turn on notifications. By doing so, you'll be the first to know about our latest releases. The first remains of the Titanoboa were found at the bottom of a Colombian mine in Corregion. However, changes in the position of continents and climate make it difficult to establish the exact location of its habitat, so we must allow for a margin of error. Researchers found that the snake lived about 60 million years ago. It appeared after the death of the dinosaurs. At that time, life on Earth was recovering and gaining strength for several million years. The fossils of this ancient snake were a real find for the scientists. They found as many as 28 individuals, which provided valuable information. Before that, only vertebrae had been found in South America, so this creature remained a mystery to researchers. It wasn't until 2008 that Jason Head, at the head of his group, described such a species as the Titanoboa. The giant snake lived during the Paleocene, when many of the planet's living creatures were giant due to gravitational and atmospheric changes. Not so long ago, the largest snake that ever existed was thought to be Gigantophis, which reached a length of 10 meters. However, the Titanoboa surpasses it in both length and weight, and is considered to be more dangerous than its predecessor because it hunted very large prey. The Titanoboa is not called the largest snake in the world for nothing. It could exceed 15 meters in length and weigh up to a ton. Its widest part was 1 meter in diameter, and its mouth had a structure that allowed it to swallow prey that exceeded its width. The mouth would open almost horizontally, allowing the dead prey to fall directly into the food canal. Titanoboa had large scales that are preserved in the layers next to the remains as imprints. These scales covered its body completely, including its massive head. The Titanoboa had pronounced fangs, a massive upper jaw, and a mobile lower jaw. The snake had small eyes, and its nasal ducts were barely visible. The head was indeed very large relative to the rest of the body, which was justified by the size of the prey it fed on. The body had an uneven thickness, after the head began peculiar thin neck vertebrae, after which the snake thickened to the middle and then narrowed to the tail. Of course, individuals of the Titanoboa have not been preserved in a way that would allow us to determine their coloration. However, scientists believe that the snake had a camouflage coloring since it led a secretive lifestyle. Presumably, its coloration resembled that of a modern python, a dark green shade of scales and dark ring-shaped spots all over the body. It's unlikely that the giant snake had a bright coloration. All snakes are cold-blooded, and the Titanoboa was no exception. As a result, the snake's habitat must have been warm or hot, with a tropical or subtropical climate. The average annual temperature for this snake must have been at least 33 degrees Celsius. A warm climate allowed these snakes to reach enormous sizes. Specialist Mark Denny states that the Titanoboa was so enormous that it produced massive amounts of heat from its metabolic processes. Because of this, the ambient temperature around this creature must have been 4 or 6 degrees lower than what many other scientists claim. Otherwise, the snake would have overheated. It preferred to hide in muddy rivers and lakes, from where it conducted its hunts. Snakes of this size moved extremely slowly, rarely crawled out of their shelters, and did not climb trees like many boa constrictors and pythons do. In confirmation of this, scientists draw an analogy with the modern anaconda, which has a similar lifestyle. Based on the structure of its teeth, some scientists believe that the snake mainly fed on fish, since no fossil remains of large prey have been found inside the skeletons of giant snakes. However, Due to the sedentary lifestyle and physiology of the snake, it is believed that it could not have consumed large prey. On the other hand, other scientists believe that the huge body of the snake required a significant amount of energy, which it simply could not get from fish. Therefore, there is speculation that its victims could have been large mammals that lived in the same area. There is also a belief that the snake did not hunt in the typical way pythons do. It was initially thought that the Titanoboa wrapped its prey in rings and squeezed it, breaking its bones and interrupting its breath. In reality, the snake used its camouflage to hide in muddy water and lurk on the bottom. When the prey approached the body of water, the snake would make a swift dash, grab the prey with its powerful jaws, and instantly break its bones. This hunting method is similar to the way crocodiles hunt. Like anacondas and boa constrictors, the Titanoboa was intent on conserving energy. It moved only when it was hungry after a long digestion of its previous food. These creatures may have been prone to cannibalism, which confirms their solitary lifestyle. There is a possibility that these snakes were territorial creatures and defended their territory against other individuals, as their food supply was limited due to their size. Although the Titanoboa was a giant snake, it was not the only large creature of its era. There were many other giant animals that competed with it. For example, Carbonomys turtles, whose remains are often found in swamps and lakes next to the remains of the Titanoboa, could have clashed with the snake. The turtle's jaws were powerful enough to bite part of the snake's torso. In turn, the Titanoboa could only injure the turtle's head, because the force of the bite would definitely not be enough to break the shell. Another competitor of the Titanoboa could have been giant crocodiles. They could perceive the Titanoboa as both a rival in the food chain and as prey. The reason for the extinction of the Titanoboa is simple: it lies in climate change, which acutely affected the cold-blooded reptile. The Titanoboa adapted well to high temperatures but could not tolerate low temperatures. Therefore, the movement of the continents and the gradual cooling led to the slow extinction of these snakes. Scientists believe that due to global warming, the Titanoboas may return. Millions of years of adaptation to higher temperatures cause animals to grow in size. Modern anacondas and boas may evolve into a species similar to the Titanoboa, but it will take millions of years. The Titanoboa has remained in popular culture. For example, in 2011, a 10-meter mechanical model of this giant snake was created, and the team of creators plans to make the snake in full size, all 15 meters. This snake leaves a lasting impression. It is enough just to look at the size of its skeleton. The Titanoboa occupied the top position in the Paleocene food chain and was also a true giant of its era.